الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلوات الله وسلامه وبركاته عليه يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن خير الكلام كلام الله جل في العلا وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار فيا معاشر الإخوة مرحبا بكم في هذه الأيام العشر التي هي تعتبر أفضل أيام الدنيا على الإطلاق كما أخبر بذلك الصادق المصدوق عليه الصلاة والسلام فقال في عدة روايات صحيحة فقال عليه الصلاة والسلام ما من أيام العمل الصالح فيهن أحب إلى الله من هذه العشر وفي رواية عن جابر بن عبد الله أفضل أيام الدنيا وأحب الأيام من الله هذه العشر فعن عبد الله بن قرط فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كذلك قال الأفضل الأيام وأحب الأيام من الله تبارك وتعالى هذه العشر الأيام التي نحن فيها يا معاشر الإخوة فماذا قدمنا وما أخرنا في هذه الأيام هل ادخرنا شيئا استعدادا للموت استعدادا للقاء الله تبارك وتعالى فإن موعد الموت فإنه قريب وإن كنا نرى ذلك بعيدا ولكنه قريب فيا معاشر الإخوة You'll find in the hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and those narrations that's been authenticated that we are in the greatest days and the most virtuous days of the year. Even like we know, like Imashul Ikhwa, that we have established clearly that these days are more virtuous than the last 10 days of Ramadan. They are more virtuous and more beloved to Allah than the last 10 days of Ramadan. What have we done in these days? Have we fasted? Have we gave some type of sadaqah or charity to those who are in need? Have we did something to establish for ourselves some type of good in preparation for meeting Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala very soon? For death is close to all of us than our own shoelaces. As we know the poet says in his poetry, لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مُصَبَّحٌ فِي أَهْلِهِ والموت أدنى من شراك نعله وقد حفت الجنة بالمكاره والنار بالتي نفوس تشتهي مع أن كل واحد منهما إلينا أدنى كالشراك في نعلينا As the poet says in his poetry, all of us come upon the morning. Every morning it's a ni'mah that Allah puts his soul back in our bodies so we can come upon another day. And death is close to us than our own shoelaces. For verily the hellfire, it is surrounded and encircled by hardships. And that which is, verily the hellfire is encompassed by desires and ease. and that which pertaineth to paradise is circled and it is one encompass around hardships and difficulties. Even though one of us are going to go to those two places more closer to us than our own shoelaces. For ya ma'ash al-ikhwa. These are the greatest days in which the Prophet ﷺ generalized in the hadith. As we said, the message of Allah clearly said, ma min ayyam al-amalu salihu fihin. He said, there are not any days in which we know in usul, which nakiratun fi siyaqin nafi, mu'akkadatun bi harf al-jar min, fatu'ufu tufidu al-umum al-qat'i. For when the message of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he mentioned, he generalized by mentioning indefinite when he said ayyamin. What is indefinite in the context of a negation. What has been emphasized with harf al-jar min, that has been emphasized with the actual harf al-jar min, that has been put in it harf al-jar from the days, which puts emphasis even more, which generalizes any day. That these days that we're in are the most virtuous and beloved to Allah. Have we took it to opportunity in order to establish some type of happiness in the heart of the Muslim? Or did we take advantage of these days and being more dramatic and more negative and more detrimental upon society? What have we done in these days that we actually fast in which we know which is the authentic position and the correct position in which the Messenger of Allah, likewise, the Sahaba used to do in these days. As you'll come in the narrations, which is on the authority, on Hunayda ibn Khalid, that he says, وَقَالَتْ لَهُمْ رَأَتُ حَدَّثَتْنِي بَعْتُ نِسَاءِ النَّبِيِّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَنَّهُ كَانَ يَصُومُ تِسْعًا يعني مِنْ ذِي الْحِجَّةِ وَيَوْمَ عَاشُورَى وَكَذَلِكَ صَوْمُ رَمَضَانِ. For the message of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as it comes in the narration of the authority of Hunayda ibn Khalid, that he said his wife told him that I was informed from some of the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said that he used to fast 9 days, not 10, because 10 is the day to eat. 9 days from these 10 days of the Hijjah. So the message of Allah, what is the sunnah that has been affirmed, and also what Hafsa had informed, is that the Messenger of Allah used to fast during these days because he knew, alayhi salatu wasalam, that these affairs or the actions that are done are more beloved to Allah than any day of the year. To the point where we know the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wasalam, put emphasis way on another matter that he also mentioned and said, where he said, alayhi salatu wasalam, walal jihad fi sabilillah, when they asked him, even in fighting in the cause of Allah. And we know, ya ma'ash al-ikhwa, of what jihad is considered of the highest level in which the message of Allah has called it, dharwat al-siname, what is the highest level of Islam, which is in it, of what a person puts forth, of sacrificing himself and his life and his money and his wealth, and what will be put as a risk factor in which his family and his kids will be left behind after he dies. And despite of that, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that righteous actions in these days are better than that. Despite of one case in which he said, alayhi salatu wasalam, where he said, except the person that went out with his money and his wealth and what he put forth, and he did not come back with anything of that which is in the least. For ya ma'ash al-ikhwa, for verily these days is the days in which where a lot of sunnah have been left off from the sunnah in which we see that has been totally, if not has become totally dead, except who Allah has given tawfiq to realize the great virtue of certain acts in which we'll explain. For verily, ya ma'ash al-ikhwa, number one, as Al-Hafidh ibn Rajab, rahimahullah, that he mentioned in his book called Lata'if al-Ma'arif, that he said, rahimahullah, he said that these days in which if a person performs a righteous action, أَنَّ الْعَمَلَ الْمَفْضُولِ فِي الْوَقْتِ الْفَاضِلِ يَلْتَحِقْ بِالْعَمَلِ الْفَاضِلِ فِي غَيْرِهِ يَعْنِي فِي هَذِهِ الْعَشْرِ الْأُوَلِ مِنْ شَهْرِ ذِي الْقِعْدَةِ. That he said, al-amal al-mafdool, that an action that is virtuous, that in this particular time, which is virtuous, that something that is virtuous, that outside the month of Ramadan, that it will become at a level that is even more virtuous, which is a clear indication that righteous actions in these days have now been doubled. If one realizes the importance of these days, knowing of what is in it of tremendous reward, for verily, ya ma'ashal ikhwa, take advantage. Maybe come to a person that is in need. Maybe come to a person, just give a mere smile in his face. Try to relieve him of some difficulty or some type of hardship that he's facing in his life, in which you're able to remove, in which in these days it will be raised another level and another degree, and it will be put on a status that is so virtuous, in which a lot of us are heedless and inadvertent of in these days. For verily, ya ma'ashal ikhwa, for verily these days and times in which we're in, there's a lot of sunnah that are left off, and this sunnah will explain in the second khutbah, bi'idhnillah jalla wa az. And we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, an yuwaffiqna wa iyaakum bil qiyam bil amal as-salih fi hal ayyam wa an naghtanim al fursa likay nataqarrab ilayhi jalla fil ula innahu waliyyu dhalika wal qadir alayh. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له الملك الحق المبين وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله سيد ولدي آدم أجمعين صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد فيا معاشر الإخوة. From those virtuous actions which the people have left off in these days is الرفع بالتكبير وإن لم تكن هذه السنة قد أماتها كثير من الناس. For you will find يا معاشر الإخوة, from what is from the established, affirmed sunan of the Messenger of Allah during these days, is to raise the voices in talbiyah and takbir. For those who are making hajj, then they will perform the takbir, not just at the end of the salawat and what a lot of people are accustomed to doing. All throughout the day, whether it be in your household, in your car, in those places in which you're able to affirm and establish and bring life back to the sunnah that has been put to death by a lot of people, in which you'll find, ya ma'ash al-ikhwa, anna Aba Huraira radiyallahu anhu, Abdullah ibn Umar, kana yukabbirani fi suq wa yukabbiru nas ma'a takbirihima. For you will find the hadith on the authority of Abu Huraira and Abdullah ibn Umar that during these days, that they used to perform the takbir in their marketplaces. And then the people were likewise takbir along with their takbir of saying, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd. For ya ma'ashu al-ikhwa, the great Imam Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen gave a tremendous benefit, where he said that we know that the shaitan is described in the book of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala as being khannas. يعني عند سماعه لذكر الله يخنس يعني ينكمش ويتقلص ويصخر حتى يفر ويتهرب. He says when the mess that we know that the shaitan is considered khannas, that when he hears the remembrance of Allah, he becomes humiliated and small to the point where he flees away. He says, and this can actualize by a person making his takbir in his household, from the benefits of making takbir in these days. So even in your household, say Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah. Maybe perhaps that the shaitan, the unseen shaitan, will become small and become vilified and become humiliated until he flees away, which gives the benefits of this particular sunnah in which the Messenger of Allah has established, in which you'll find, Ya Ma'ash al-Ikhwa, as Yazid ibn Abi Ziyad, that he mentioned in the narration, in which Imam al-Marwazi mentioned in Ahkam al-Eidain, and also al-Hafidh ibn Rajab, that he mentioned in Lata'if al-Ma'arif, that he also mentioned and said, he said, Ra'aytu Sa'id ibn Jubair, wa Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Layla, wa Mujahid ibn Jabr. He said, man ra'aytu min fuqaha'in nas, yukabbirun, ya'ni fi hadhi al-ashr. He says that I've seen the great a'imma from the Salaf, from the ulama of tafsir who took their ilm from Ibn Abbas, and from them was Sa'id ibn Jubair, from the greatest students of Ibn Abbas, and a great imam from the a'imma Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Layla, and also Mujahid from the ulama of tafsir, likewise who took his ilm from Ibn Abbas, said that they used to make takbir in these days. And for these days that he said, and what I've seen from the fuqaha of the people, the scholars of jurisprudence, doing in these days of performing takbir, and these days of which is considered the best days of the dunya, and also likewise with Sulaiman ibn Mihran, that he said that during these days, he says, Kana nasu kabbiru. He says to the point, he says, that also likewise, he says, Kana kalmithli al-amwaj. وَأَنَا أُشَبِّ التَّكْبِيرِ بِالْأَمْوَاجِ مِنْ كَثْرَتِهَا وَلَكِنِّنِي أَرَى أَنَّهُمْ قَدْ نَقَصُوا لِتَرْكِهِمَ التَّكْبِيرِ. He says that I will give resemblance, he says, of those from the Sahaba and those who came after them, from the Salaf who came and likewise conveyed this religion in an authentic manner, that he said that they used to make takbir to the point whereas if it was like waves of the ocean, due to the abundance of it. Listen to this last part that Sulaiman ibn Mihran said. He says, "Wa inni qad ara an-nas qad naqasu." That was about 800 years ago. Verily, I've seen the people now, they have become incomplete due to the fact that they have left off the takbir. And I think this is clear with what we see today. Either they have now restricted it to only after the salawat, so they made it restricted to a now specific place. And also likewise, if you know how it's been done, it's likewise incorrect, or they don't do it at all. To let you know how the times are giving more detrimental, where the people are going further away from the sunnah and establishing something that's incorrect in opposition to the sunnah. For that is from the affairs, Ya Ma'ash al-Ikhwa, where it's highly emphasized that we do in these days in order to draw close to Allah, تبارك وتعالى. Likewise, Ya Ma'ash al-Ikhwa, that confirms in the ayah in which Allah تبارك وتعالى clearly says in his book, where he says, وَأَذِّ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالَ وَعَلَى كُلِّ ضَامِرِ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍ عَمِيقٍ لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَهُمْ وَيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ وَيَذْكُرُوا اسْمَ اللَّهَ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْلُومَاتٍ عَلَى مَا رَزَقَهُمْ مِنْ بَهِيمَةِ الْأَنْعَامِ فَكُلُوا مِنْهَا وَأَطْعِمُوا الْبَائِسَ الْفَقِيرِ. In which the Prophet ﷺ, during these days, he used to perform an abundance of remembrance of Allah, not just the takbir, which comes in the ayah in which Allah lays down, which is of hajj, which is the arkan in which the people are performing these days. And we have to ask ourselves, are we making preparation for hajj? And upon the what is the strongest opinion, that the Hajj not only removes the minor sins, it removes the major ones as well. And what Al-Hafidh ibn Hajar mentioned in Fath, what he mentioned in Fath al-Bari, which is Sharh al-Sahih al-Bukhari, in which you'll find the great Imam, Rabi' ibn Hadi al-Madkhali Hafidh Allah, Raghba Unuf al-Hizbiyin, as what he mentioned in likewise, in regards to this hadith, that he says what is the strongest opinion, that Hajj removes the major and the minor sins. So why have we had not our passports in our pockets ready to go as soon as Allah opens up the opportunity? Because I know it's a lot of people, including ourselves, that have committed so many acts that we probably are shy to meet and stand up from our Lord that he would bring it in front of us. in which we need this type of maghfirah from Allah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. Faya ma'ash al-ikhwa. Also likewise, what's incoming upon these days, of what a person likewise will perform on the day of the Eid of slaughtering. And we know the strongest opinion is it should not be left off, ma'al qudra, for the one who has the financial capability, that leaving off slaughter during the day of the Eid is something that is in opposition to the sunnah, in which you'll find that the majority of ahl ilm saying that it's sunnah mu'akkada. It's a highly emphasized sunnah. It's as if wajib is here, and sunnah mu'akkada is like right there. Rather, there's narrations that proves the obligation of it. But also likewise, there's our narrations that proves that it's not an obligation if the person does not have the ability. But a person who has the money, he should not leave off the sunnah. For number one, of the tremendous virtues that it contains, of drawing close to Allah during these days. And that is the confirmation of the ayah, which comes in Surah Al-Kawthar, in which we read, which is from, if not the shortest surah in the Quran, فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ. Pray Salatul Eid, then go slaughter the sacrificial animals, which is incumbent upon the one who has the financial capability. فَيَا مَعَاشَ الْإِخْوَةِ. All of the ummahat al-ibadat tajtami' fi hal ayam. All of the heads of the tremendous affairs of worship gathers in these 10 days of what is in it, of all the actions being doubled, and what is in it of hajj, and what is in it of sacrificing for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and what is in it of yawm arafah, where Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala descends and he brags and he mentions to the angels praising him of those who have came to him shu'than ghubara yatuna min kulli fajin amiq. He said that they came to me disheveled in a very disoriented manner. All of that coming from those remote distant places in order to establish this worship of him tabaraka wa ta'ala. Descending in a manner, ashiyat arafah, which those who are not making and performing hajj in their cities, in which the Messenger of Allah came up with another sunnah, giving us another opportunity to remove these filthy sins that are upon us, in which he said, alayhi salatu wassalam, and ahtasibu ala Allah, ya'ni siyam yawm arafah, an yukaffir as-sanata al-madiyah wal-mustaqbala. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam likewise mentioned and said, that on a day of yawm arafah, in which also likewise the mention, in which that particular day is considered from the greatest days of this dunya, of this world, in which we know, ya ma'ashir al-ikhwah, that this dunya is cursed. And what is in it that is cursed? And what's the hadith which comes to Tirmidhi on the authority of Abu Huraira, radiallahu anhu, الدنيا ملعونة ملعون ما فيها إلا ذكر الله وما والاه وعالما ومتعلما. This dunya is cursed, cursed of everything that is in it. And the hadith is in Tirmidhi. وَحَسَّنَهُ الْإِمَامَ الْأَلْبَانِي وَصَحَّحَهُ بَعْضُ الْأَئِمَّةِ. But that hadith has been established. Also likewise, who said it's authentic, the great Imam Abdul Aziz bin Baz, rahimahullah, that he said that this dunya and this world is cursed and everything is in it except the remembrance of Allah or anything that is similar to it, meaning of righteous actions. And a person who's a scholar and the one who's learning and the one who's disseminating the knowledge and the one who is taking it. فَيَا مَعَشُ الْإِخْوَةِ. He said that the meaning of مَلْعُونَ here is مَذْمُومَ. As the great Imam Sheikh Saleh Fawzan even explained the hadith, where he said that the meaning of مَلْعُونَ يَعْنِي مَذْمُومَ. That the meaning of curse, meaning that it's dispraised and it's condemned and it's vilified and it's looked down, except what is utilized for the obedience of Allah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. And if this dunya, if you let it, take you away from those duties that Allah has obliged upon you, then you have fell into the meaning of the hadith of this dunya with it being cursed, meaning dispraised and condemned, where it took you away from what is the ultimate goal, which is preparing for death, for utilizing it in order to what? To perform an abundance of righteous actions, to establish the tawheed of Allah, and to establish the sunnah, and to perform an abundance of righteous actions. For verily, that's the meaning of the hadith. For ya ma'ash al-ikhwa. For now you'll find of Yawm Arafah, in which one is supposed to perform that fast in that particular day, in which the messenger said, alayhi salatu wasalam, that I contemplate the reward from Allah, that he will remove my righteous actions. I will remove, and he will what? Remove my evil actions from the previous year and the year that's following. So you now we not only have of what is in these 10 days, of also what is in it of Hajj, of what is in it of Salah, of what is in it of Siyam, of what is in it of Udhiyah, of what is in it of Dhikr of Allah, and also raising the voices with the Dhikr of Allah, and remember the Quran, and also likewise what the Salaf used to perform in these days, not only a fasting, but even standing at night, in which Sa'id ibn Jubair, إذا دخل العشر, of what Ibn Rajab had even mentioned in Lataif al-Ma'arif. And he said, كان سعيد بن جبير يجتهد اجتهادا شديدا حتى لا يكاد يقدر عليه. That سعيد بن جبير, that he said when these 10 days came, he said he used to be so diligent and hardworking and performing righteous actions until he was not able to do any more. From Salat, Siyam, Qiyam fil Layl. For brothers, if you're not able to fast, at least after Isha, stand at least 20 minutes to your Lord. What will it hurt? Stand 20 minutes with your Lord. And I've highly said, and if wallahi, brothers, thumma tallahi, if you've seen fasting, if you observe fasting in these 9 days, wallahi al-azim, and if you did it with ikhlas and sincerity, you will see a change starting to occur in your life. You will start to see your iman start to go up. Now you're starting to have desire to do more and more and more. لماذا؟ لأن العمل الصالح يجر إلى أخته. Why? Because righteous actions that it drink it now brings a person to a what? To do another one with his from his sisters to give you a what? Incentive to do more and more. And evil actions is the opposite. You do one evil action, it will pull you to do another one, and another one, and another one. These days was what the virtuous, the Salaf, realized the importance of these days. They knew it was the best days during the last days of Ramadan. They realized the high status of these days. Have we realized it? Are we fasting? Are we making qiyam? Are we standing at night? If you can't do an hour, do 20 minutes. Do 10 minutes. Do something. The important thing is you do a little small thing and be consistent with it. Even if it's 10 minutes. If you do that every day, that is more beloved to Allah, as we know the hadith. أَحَبُ الْأَعْمَالِ لَلَّهِ أَدْوَمُهُ وَإِنْ قَلْ كَمَا أَخْبَرَ بِذَلِكَ الصَّادِقُ الْمَسْدُوقِ. That the most beloved actions to Allah is the most consistent, even if it's something minute and small. فَيَا مَعَشَ الْإِخْوَةِ. These are from the virtuous day, of virtuous actions, in which one that he should do in these days, in which the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in which Allah mentioned in his book, وَالْبُدْنَ جَعَلْنَاهَا لَكُمْ مِنْ شَعَائِرِ اللَّهِ لَكُمْ فِيهَا خَيْرٌ. فَذْكُرُوا اسْمُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ صَوَافِ فَإِذَا وَجَبَتْ جُنُوبُهَا فَكُلُوا مِنْهَا وَأَطْعِمُوا الْقَانِعَ وَالْمُعْتَرِ كَذَلِكَ سَخَّرْنَاهَا لَكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. لَا يَنَالُ اللَّهَ لُحُومُهَا وَلَا دِمَاؤُهَا وَلَكِنْ يَنَالُهُ التَّقْوَى مِنْكُمْ كَذَلِكَ سَخَّرَهَا لَكُمْ لتكبر الله على ما هداكم وبشر المحسنين إن الله يدافع عن الذين آمنوا إن الله لا يحب كل خوان كفور. As he says, تبارك وتعالى, he says on these days, in which you have put forth that sacrificial animal. And you have mentioned the name of Allah when it's been lined up to be sacrificed. And once now it's become lifeless and it's laying on its side now. He says, eat from it and give to the qani' and the mu'tar. Give to those who are needy, the less fortunate. Give to the ones who's in need. Give to the ones who do not ask, even though they're in a state of being in need likewise. And those likewise who are begging, in which the son of the Prophet ﷺ, that he broke down the meat into three, thalathatu athlath, that he broke the meat down into three thirds, a third for himself and for his family, a third for those who are in need, and a third for his neighbors and his friends. And if a person slaughters, that he slaughtered for the first, the number one is a dutton, which is the sheep, that it has to at least complete 6 months in order for it to be adequate so it can fulfill the obligation, so it can be acceptable by law. So if one slaughters a sheep, as far as the age, it has to be at least 6 months. In regards to al-ma'iz, or the goat, it has to be at least completed 1 year. And if it's a baqar, and if it's a cow, has to complete 2 years. And if it's an ibil from the, and if it's from the camels, it has to be at least completed 5 years. In order for it to be adequate, and in order for to fulfill the obligation. Likewise, it has to be free of defects and blemishes. From those blemishes is that it cannot have al-awar, wal-aruj, wal-marr, wal-hizal. Or likewise that which is from qatr al-batr. Also likewise has to be free of any type of blemishes. From it being one-eyed or having some type of discrepancy or some blemish in regards to it being sick to the point where it's skinny or mutilated or one-eyed or crippled or having some type of sickness. Why? Because during these occasions, Ya Ma'ash al-Ikhwa, one, he offers the best of what he has for Allah. It only happens one time during the year. So why not take one time for the year and one occasion to give to what you have of the best for your Lord, if you have the ability? And that's the meaning of the ayah where Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says in this book, where he says, tabarak wa ta'ala, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, anfiqu mimma kasabtum. وَمِمَّا أَخْرَجَنَا لَكُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ وَلَا تَيَمَّمُوا الْخَبِيثَ مِنْهُ تُنْفِقُونَ وَلَسْتُمْ بِآخِرِي إِلَّا أَنْ تُغْمِدُوا فِيهِ وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ حَمِيدٌ الشَّيْطَانُ يَعِدُكُمُ الْفَقْرَ وَيَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ وَاللَّهُ يَعِدُكُم مَّغْفِرَةً مِّنْهُ وَفَضْلًا وَاللَّهُ وَاسِعٌ عَلِيمٌ يُؤْتِي الْحِكْمَةَ مَن يَشَاءُ وَمَن يُؤْتَ الْحِكْمَةَ فَقَدْ أُوتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا وَمَا يَذَّكَّرُ إِلَّا أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. What Allah Ta'ala says in his book, he says, O you who believe, spend of what, of those wholesome affairs of what we have given you and what we brought forth of the earth, of which is halal. Do not put forth of what is the most lowliest of what you have. And you will not take it yourself, except that you will close your eyes to it. Know that Allah is Ghaniyun Hamid. He is all self-sufficient and all praise. And what Shaitan has promised the creation, which Allah Ta'ala has informed. Shaitan promises you poverty. That if you give for Allah, you're going to be poor. If you give for Allah, you're not going to have better. Keep it in your pocket. Don't do it for Allah. Don't you realize you got to buy some clothes? Don't you realize you got to buy those shoes that you want? Don't you realize that you want to eat something tonight? Don't you realize these affairs of your children? Even these days, a lot of people don't even care about their kids anymore and their families. They trifling with that. But these shaitan goes to that level. A shaitan ya'idukum al-faqr wa ya'murukum bil-fahsha. He promises you poverty. And he commands you to do all types of abominable acts. And Allah promised you forgiveness from him and his virtue. And Allah is wasi'un alim. He gives hikmah to whom he wills. And whoever has been given hikmah, he has been given a lot of good. No one will take heed except the one who truly has upright, correct, sound understanding. For ya ma'ashul ikhwan. For in these days we give forth the best for Allah. Where Allah to Allah tabarik wa ta'ala said that the true test is what you're given of what you don't want to give. When you're holding back and saying, I don't want to give it. When you feel that feeling, that's when the test comes in. But when you just go in your closet and say, get rid of this, give it to the masjid. Where's the test in that, ya ma'ashul ikhwa? Farq bayna tasadduq wa takhallus. It's the difference between giving charity and getting rid of something. The test comes when you don't want to give it. Of what you hold them back. And that's when the iman really shows where your level is. That's what establishes it. And in this day, during the Eid, ya ma'ashul ikhwa, during this Eid that your only Allah has made obligatory once in a year, if you have the ability, give the best of what you have for him subhanahu wa ta'ala in these blessed days, in which you'll find that Ibn al-Qayyim, likewise, he mentioned and said that these days in which all of these affairs have been gathered up, from them being the first best of 10 days during the year, also likewise, which is in of Yawm al-Arafah, which Allah descends in it. Also likewise, on the day which Allah remits sins on the day of Yawm al-Arafah. And also likewise, on Yawm al-Nahr, which the Prophet had also have informed that they are the most virtuous days likewise. After Yawm al-Arafah is Yawm al-Nahr, or Yawm al-Qarr. Yawm al-Nahr, which is the day of the Eid, and the days that come after that from Yawm al-Tarwiyah. He said, for all these types of ibadat to come together, he says, no wonder why they considered the best days of the year. For ya ma'ashul ikhwa, we ask Allah to give us tawfiq in these days of what is remaining. For those who have not fast, try to fast these last 3 or 4 days. Try it. After Isha, pray 10 minutes. Soon as Isha comes and finish, go home. Everyone say, babe, I just want to go in my room. Let me pray for 10 minutes. Do that consistently. Every day. 10 minutes. Is that going to hurt? How many of us take 10 minutes just to lollygag to talk to people? 10 minutes for Allah. And the most virtuous days of the year. We need to sacrifice in order to prepare ourselves to when we meet him. Jalla fil ula. Hadha wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wa subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdik. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت استغفرك وأتوب إليك وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وأقيم الصلاة